ConsciousAzine.com Chronicles. Hello everyone. So today I wanted to make this video. Organic portals are unascension, and that's reverberfractal. That's all the way from not having the ascension through the higher heart, and also all the way to reincarnation. And never will they reach the higher realms, it appears. And they're denser than us. They are third dimensional, and we're not just third dimensional. We reach down into the third dimension. And there is a difference in that. So it's very interesting how much they repeat cycles, you know, just of thinking, of ways of being. You know, it takes your will force to get out of any addiction. And, you know, there's a lot of souled humans that are addicted to things, but we have society set up that way as well. So we've been bred that way quite a lot as well. But anyway, generally I notice that organic portals repeat cycles more. You know, how many lives will you take to, you know, sort of evolve to a new rung of complexity? And, you know, they're the very simple people. They're the people who only see and believe what they see and think that everything is as it seems. But us souled humans know that everything is not what it seems. There's something more to the story all the time. Anyway, I noticed that they're not ascensive. Now, you know, they're the people that keep reincarnating, but they've set the world up so that you will too, because you've got to attain the light, and it takes 14 years, 2 7-year cell renewal cycles, so if you don't do it the first time, you'll get it the second, but 14 years to create the immortal light body, you know, so keep at it, and don't give up after the first 5 years if it's not working. You know, in that second 5-year period, stuff will really start to take off more. So start seeking, and don't think that, you know, it's going to be too hard, it's worthless, because it is worth it. And this is immortalization. The way we leave ourselves here after we die, our thoughts and so on. And the true, most worthy way of immortalizing yourself, not trying to do it through having children or popping out babies. That's the other way, but it's surmountable a lot more by the world. What if the kid is affected epigenetically and doesn't really carry your legacy on? Then your legacy dies, you know? And notice this playlist is called Organic Portal Legacy List, as in they're becoming that. The different meaning of legacy is, in this context, different to the aforementioned context. And in this context, I mean an old item. So this playlist is called Organic Portal Legacy List. But before, I was talking about leaving your legacy behind, your corpus. Not your corpse, not just your corpse, but your corpus, which is your body of work. Like, I'm creating a lot of these videos, this is now part of my corpus, or my body of work, which is always got to do with higher knowledge, not just copied peer-reviewed journal stuff or lower science of the physical world. That can play its role, and, you know, if they're a proper scientist doing it for real, because there's a lot of, let's say, pseudoscience going on these days. Anyway, so the organic portals I find really repeat cycles more. and build a kind of special bridge called the Rainbow Bridge, which is when both brain hemispheres, not just the left side of the brain, but the right side of the brain too, have a magnetically suspended rainbow bridge. You know, rainbow as in the electromagnetic spectrum, obviously, and it's magnetically suspended. And this is called the Anta Karana, and you switch up through that, through to the higher mind. And obviously that's a way to connect with your higher self. And this is what I've been mentioning in other videos. And so that's how we do it. And things like garlic, they say desync your brain hemispheres, and you find it maybe a bit harder while you're cleansing, and you feel sometimes dragged into the world a lot, and depressed and stuff, and nihilistic and so on. But on the way out then, and garlic is killing things on the way, so I do actually continue to recommend it, because it's not just some poison, in my opinion, because that desyncing of the hemispheres, it has its purpose, and it really seems to purge a lot of little parasites out of the body, and large. So it's a fantastic healer, in my opinion. And, you know, shamanic practice is often, you know, located right next to ordeal poisons and stuff, you know, for sanity. And if you don't know how this works, I can take you through it. I do offer that service. Check my services and merchandise bartering page, you know, because that's part of consciouszine.net too. I have a lot of offerings in there, so check it out. You might be interested in a few or just one. I don't just do donation-based videos. I give consultations and everything. So all kinds of services I offer. Anyway, and one of them is, you know, teaching on psychedelics. I'll teach you privately. But, you know, organic portals, never do they seem to step out of certain cycles, like trying not to kill, for instance. And if they do things, remember, it's always mimicked. They mimic the higher centers, because their higher centers from the heart up, chakras, are devoid. And, you know, so they don't have higher light. That's why they don't do higher light seeking, yeah? It all becomes obvious once you get the esoteric parts of all this, once you look under the rug. So it can't be swept away when we are with people like myself who like to inspect reality for themselves, you know, and I just think, you know, ergo sum, bring together the information that was gathered. I think, therefore, I am that thing, you know, that, yeah, it has some merit to it. I get ergo sum. That's a nice little wording or nomenclature or moniker, ergo sum. You know, just the sum of it all. Anyway, I think organic portals repeat a lot more cycles. So it's always pain addiction cycles as well, and not necessarily drugs or psychedelic plant entheogens or anything like that, but sugar, mental instable thoughts, or coffee, or, you know, much more ordinary things they are addicted to. Weird shit. Pills from the pharmaceuticals. Like, they're addicted to the death industries, and it's pretty ridiculous. It's a clear sign of either subconscious sabotage or unconscious being. You know, and so this is one way you can tell who's an organic portal in your life, when they're addicted to all the synthetic stuff of society. And it's weird, because they're denser, it's like they almost don't get affected by it in the same way as more sensitive souled humans do, because these dense packaged synthetic market supermarkets type foods, overprocessed, etc., and all synthetic ingredients which are natural, aka made in a laboratory but not really natural, you know, these things clog the body. There's many films you can look up on how that makes you different. You know, that changes your makeup, your body and everything. So anyway, just check these sort of societally addicted cycle people who repeat cycles. It could be an organic portal.